Panda, 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 panda. I got broads in Atlanta. Just to lean in the family. Credit cards in the scammers. Hitting no licks in the van. Legacies, phantom. Wait and see, look like a panda. Going out like a Montana. Honey killers on the helmets. Legacies, phantom. Wait and see, panda. Pocket swoop, Danny. Selling ball, Danny.
Hello, Year 5. You're probably wondering, why is Mr. Odin's a panda today? I'm wondering the same. Actually, no, I'm not. You will find out in 2 minutes why I am dressed as a panda.
Hi guys, so today we are looking at non-chronological reports. I thought it would be better if I just showed you my screen, because it's quite a big document when you're looking at a non-chronological report. We're going to do a feature analysis again. So hope it's still good content for you, that you really understand and it helps you. And I'll catch you at the end. Bye-bye.
Right, guys. So what is a non-chronological report? A non-chronological report is a text which isn't written in time order. They are normally non-fiction texts which give information on a particular subject or event without referring to the order in which things happen. Okay, so a non-chronological report is basically just a report about normally something that's factual. Could be an object, could be an event. But the most important thing to note is that, okay, it is not written in time order. Okay, it is just almost like random bits of information put on a report. Okay, it is not in any specific order. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to look at an example. Okay, and I'm going to go through the features of it. So the first thing that a non-chronological report needs is a catchy heading to engage the reader and let them know what will be in the report. Okay, so this says, who doesn't love pandas? This is the heading. All right, it's very obvious from this that this is going to be about pandas, and by it saying who doesn't love pandas, it's a bit engaging, it makes it a bit interesting. Okay, right, then we'd have a brief introduction to give an overview of what will be contained within the report. So this is the introduction, very small. Pandas are the national animal of China. They are related to bears and have black eyed patches. Okay, so from that introduction, it is very obvious that this is going to be about pandas, and it tells you that they're from China. It's very brief information. Right, okay. Now, each section, okay, so this report needs to be split up into loads of different sections, and each section needs to have a subheading. So, as you can see, this is one subheading, what do pandas look like? Another one, what do pandas eat? Another one, what do pandas do? Okay, this is important because it tells the reader what's going to be in each paragraph, and as remember, it's not in time order and it's random bits of information. Okay, that's, it's so critical that you have subheadings. Okay, and this kind of backs that up. It just says information is organized into paragraphs. So this one says, what do pandas eat? Pandas are very fussy eaters. Most pandas only eat bamboo, a type of grass. Okay, a giant panda will eat half their own weight in bamboo every day. So that paragraph is organized and it's specifically about what pandas eat. It doesn't talk about anything else. Okay. Right. Next, we need to use technical language. Okay. Technical language is specific language for the object or the event you're talking about. So here we say claws. We don't say fingernails or fingers because that wouldn't be right. Okay. Remember, this is factual information. We're trying to give someone information, so we need to give them the right information and the right words to use, not the wrong words. Okay, now it's also very good to use extra information to accompany the main points. So the point here says the red panda has a long tail, and then the bit highlights is, and is the same size as a cat. Right, they didn't need to put that. They could just say the red panda has a long tail, but okay, they've given a bit of more information and it's the same size as a cat. It makes it more interesting and allows you to compare things. So that is also very important. Now, lastly, I just need to scroll down for the last... Oh, no, there's two more bits, actually. So the next thing is specific information could be placed in a box or on a bullet or in bullet points. Okay, so here is a did you know box. It gives you a very interesting fact. Now, the reason why these are good and they're put in boxes because they really pull the reader in and make sure that the reader reads this, because it's highlighted in a box, okay? And that's just really important as another form of engagement, okay? And then lastly, we can use diagrams to support the report, okay? So we got a giant panda eats bamboo, and then if we go up a tiny bit, it's just a picture of another panda, okay? Now, this report is about pandas, okay? So unless you have a picture of a panda, it's going to be quite hard for the reader to understand that. Like if you were talking about an event, for example, a festival, it would be important to have a picture of what a festival looks like. Or if you're talking about the human body, it's important to have a picture or a diagram of what the human body looks like. Okay, so this is a non-chronological report. These are the features, okay? And just to recap again, a non-chronological report is a text which isn't written in time order. That's the most important part, it's not written in time order. They're normally non-fiction texts which give information on a particular subject or even without referring to the order in which things happen. Fabulous, guys. Have a fantastic day.
I hope you guys all learned a lot there, and have a fantastic day. Make sure you check out the shout outs, because I'm sure lots of you will be on there. Bye, guys. Have a good weekend. I got plenty of stuff with Bugatti, but look how I tried this shit. Legacies, phantom, why is he killing?